are the new face of active because you're creating these algorithms, you're parlaying them into indexes, and then they get made into ETFs. Do you see your work as active stock picking?
It is in some sense, all right. The creation of this particular ETF is based on the index. And the index behind that, I create a strategy for investment. And this strategy is based on the behavioral finance aspect. But we know that the investor have a lot of behavioral biases, particularly in the downside. When people are facing the loss, we have a loss aversion. And there's a particular phenomenon we call disposition effect. Mm-hmm. So when there's information coming there and people get really overreact in the downside. So usually they are selling too fast and they are holding too long. So this particular strategy is utilize that, using this disposition effect, particularly that we use that one to create an index and to select the stocks they have least possibility that will have an impact from this of the disposition, and then laterally have the rebound from that.
Okay, so it's rules-based, and it looks for it objectively on what is most dispositioned and what's right for rebound. What kind of signals does your algorithm, does your ratio pick up when stock prices are just kind of drifting higher, melting up, indexes are making new highs, like we've seen the last few weeks?
Yeah, I mean, the index itself is based on the ratio, called Chow ratio. Mm-hmm. This ratio actually is the ratio between the return and the asymmetric volatility. So there's a way that I can measure the asymmetric volatility. The asymmetric volatility for the individual stocks provide a signaling that the stock actually have an overreaction.
Okay.
Yes.
Now, looking at UTRN's risk-adjusted return, your Sharpe ratio is 1.26, just slightly lower than USMV, which is about 1.3 or so. You claim your ETF is the new school low volatility. What do you mean by that? Explain that.
Okay. The volatility, the conventional viewpoint, is the variation of the symmetrical gain and loss. Mm-hmm. However, in reality, we are facing a lot of asymmetric gain and loss. So the algorithm I developed here is really try to protect downside based on the asymmetric volatility. So this is a new approach. Nobody actually used that before.
You talk about you're looking at behavior of investors and kind of capitalizing off of that. We know that there are algorithms linked to President Trump's tweets and subsequent pullbacks that we've seen in the markets as a result. So how does your ETF factor in tweets and the knee-jerk reaction that we get?
We don't actually pretty much to quantify the information, mm-hmm. but it's based on the some kind of mathematical algorithm. We can see that the asymmetry in the volatility sense, and they're usually caused by those information bias. We have actually some analysis find out the Chow ratio is pretty robust, especially the time when President Trump had tweets. And we see that the Chow ratio really pick up the stock, which has actually better performance during that period of time.
Oh, interesting. Okay. In terms of turnover, UTRN has incredibly high turnover. It replaces its entire portfolio pretty much every week, which crushes the annual fund turnover record for any equity ETF. I mean, look at that, 3,300%.
Yeah.
High turnover is not necessarily seen as a great thing in the ETF world.
Yeah. I think in our, we have different philosophy.
Okay.
The ETF or UTRN or UTRN X is the index. Its designing is to try to minimizing the downside risk exposure. So it's more like a hedge fund. Mm. So in order to do the hedge, you have to have a frequent rebalance. Now we are comparing the trading costs versus hedging costs. So the trading cost actually is declining over time, but the hedging costs increase more and more. So comparing with this two, I don't think the huge turnover will affect the hedging behavior for this particular fund.
All right, very quickly, any of your students coming up with an algorithm or an index that we should be aware of?
Yeah, I have a few students work with me and together, and I wish to have more people can use this.